Up until a few weeks ago, I was working as a logistician on the Aquarius, one of two rescue ships that MSF is currently on in the Mediterranean. One day, we were stationed about 25 nautical miles off the coast of Libya, west of Tripoli, where most of the departures are in international waters. That day, the sea was full of distressed boats, these impossibly thin plastic rafts and old wooden fishing boats. We have a capacity on the Aquarius of 550, but we wound up taking aboard 946, plus one, a healthy baby girl that was born on board. Being so overcapacitated was not a situation we wanted to be in. There were no other ships in the area save for a few other NGO vessels that were also beyond capacity. Frontex, the European Coast Guard, was nowhere to be seen. So we were left with the decision of overcapacitating ourselves to such an extent or risking letting people drown. This year, we have rescued so far, as of April 20th, 6,500. It's clear that our work in the Mediterranean is more important than ever now that Europe has changed its tactics and are focused on stopping the flow of migrants from reaching Europe rather than saving lives.
Stress
boats. Well, firstly, it's important to know that we never have any contact with smugglers. We don't ask if they're on the boats we encountered. We're only there to save lives. About 60% of the time we receive a call from MRCC, which is the Maritime Rescue Coordination Center in Rome. It's run by the Italian Coast Guard. They receive GPS coordinates when the distressed ships call them on a satellite phone or if they're spotted by commercial vessels in the busy shipping lanes. The rest of the time we spot the distressed boats ourselves from the bridge using radar and binoculars. Once the rescued people are on board, men, women, children, entire families. We triage them for medical problems and register them. We give them food, water, clothing, other cold weather protection. If there's dead, we place them in body bags and take them to our morgue, which is a shipping container on the forward deck. It's clear how tremendously important it is to talk to those who are especially vulnerable. We have a humanitarian affairs officer and a cultural mediator on board, and together with a medical team, they speak to the women and girls in particular, but also anyone else who wants to share their story. There are countless testimonies of people who have experienced or witnessed rape and human trafficking, and there's a real fear they're headed towards this reality when they get to Europe. So we offer them resources for an out. When we get to shore, we refer them to agencies that focus on protection. This goes for large numbers of unaccompanied male minors as well, and other vulnerable groups, such as victims of torture. Search and rescue is far from the solution. It's a stopgap measure to save lives. Last year, 5,000 people perished trying to cross the Mediterranean, and this year, the number, so far as of April 20th, is 962. And this is only confirmed deaths. The real number is much higher. MSF and NGOs overall have been criticized by Frontex and others who claim that our presence in the Mediterranean is exacerbating departures. They point to a rising share of NGO rescues over those done by EU governmental assets. However, we clearly see that Frontex has been limiting its operations in the Mediterranean and doing so using human life as political leverage and forcing us to fill the void. We're there to save lives, but it's the responsibility of European and other capable governments to provide adequate and proactive resources at sea and to implement necessary political reforms that respect human rights, so that so many desperate people are not forced into these boats, risking their lives, putting their fate in the hands of human smugglers, and at the mercy of the sea.